Sound design.
In this video, I want to talk about how to identify a comb filter. And I think the two easiest ways are number one, just to look for regular peaks and dips. And number two, just move the microphone. All right, so let's walk through this together. What is a comb filter? A comb filter is just a series of regular peaks and dips. And so to the untrained eye, this might look like a pretty strange looking comb, right? Like these are all different sizes. But if I press Option T to open my transfer function options, and I change this graph setting from a frequency scale of 1/3 octave to linear, aha! Now the regularity of those peaks and dips is a lot more clear. Now this looks like a comb, okay? So this is where the term comb filter comes from, is looking at these series of peaks and dips on a linear scale, which we almost never do, right? But that's where the term comes from. So are you going to switch your graph to linear mode to be able to identify this every time you need to do this? Probably not. What you are going to do, though, is you're going to be looking for this pattern of regularity. So not only can I see this in the amplitude, but I also see some regular things happening, weird things happening here in the phase, and the same thing in the coherence display here, right? Coherence goes to crap, coherence goes to crap, coherence goes to crap, okay? All these three things are lining up to tell us this is probably a comb filter. There's some reflection happening here. There's something happening in the air over here that I shouldn't try to do anything with my EQ. I shouldn't try to fix acoustical problems with electrical solutions. Okay, so the second thing I mentioned was just moving the microphone, right? So I'm gonna leave this on linear for now, so this will be really obvious. I'm gonna turn the measurement back on and I'm gonna move the microphone over a little bit. All right, that's interesting, right? I moved the microphone over 4 or 5 inches, and all of a sudden, our dips are peaks, and our peaks are dips. So, so this is the second indication for me that I've got a comb filter. Everything changes when I move the microphone over a little bit. Just to be sure, let's move it one more time. All right, again, our peaks have shifted around a little bit, right? And now they're not so bad. This time I moved the microphone away from the wall. So the distance from the peaks and dips have shrunk a little bit, and they're in slightly different places again, okay? So let me change this back, by the way, so you can see. Change this back to 1/3 octave. Okay, so the practice here is to be able to, with our normal 1/3 octave display here, be able to identify this regular series. And just to recap, the way I do that is by looking for these regular series of peaks and dips. And also, if I just move the microphone a little bit, does the whole thing change? And that's how you identify a comb filter. Now in the next video, let's talk about how to avoid EQing a comb filter.
Sound design.